What's good, YouTube? Y'all know this, your boy Dundog. Come back at you with another video, man. And today, man, we're going to be hopping into the subject on Ticino, man, and what he's been doing. So, make sure y'all like, share, and subscribe if y'all like this. So, we finna hop straight into it, man. We need to protect Ticino at all costs, man. Let's not talk down on him for, losing money and all that stuff like that. We all know he came down here with 20,000, came in America with 20,000, and he has pretty much lost, you know what I'm saying, half of it. And probably got like 7-8K left, something like that. I don't know, not really sure, but he said he lost over 9K, I believe. Now, man, don't talk down on him, because I want you guys to understand that what YouTubers are going to do this, man. YouTubers are not going to do this. Most YouTubers are not. They're just going to be here for the entertainment. They're going to do that. Some of them going to say they comp and all that, but they're not going to do this on the big screen and do it like he doing, streaming in front of 15,000 plus people. And you know what I'm saying, wagering and stuff over a game that's already trash from the get-go. So y'all gonna be seeing screenshots that's gonna pop up. And it's concerning this Ticino and Hank situation. Now, Hank, it seems to me as Hank was trying to troll Ticino and have a 2K League player on the player on his account by the name of BP. I honestly think Hank was trying to do it. He says he wasn't, but I believe he was, because of the simple fact. It just seems like he was, and I believe nothing would have ever been said or done about it, and Ticino wouldn't have known if some, I guess it was a subscriber, y'all gonna see the screenshot, as you can see, he had told him, you know what I'm saying, BP might be playing on his account, because, like, if he don't stream, then BP is playing on his account, and I'm not surprised that Hank would do something like that, because we all know Hank is sort of a troll, he plays a lot, Hank is a troll. Like, even if Hank says he wasn't going to do it, I believe he was going to do it. So, they were raising for $4,000, and Hank was allegedly about to have somebody on his account. Now, how would you feel if somebody, if you raging somebody for $4,000, and they're going to have somebody better than you? So, keep in mind, put yourself as Hank. You're Hank, but you're letting somebody play that's better than you. So, how would you feel if you were Ticino? You thinking you playing one person, but the person you are playing is better than the person you thought you were playing. So keep that in mind as well. Now, Hank does all this talking about Ticino saying this and that, and saying he losing, you know what I'm saying, just basically losing money, like he just ain't good or something, like he just a scrub for even coming out, like he just really handing out money to folks. Y'all guys have to understand this. If Hank is saying that, he's basically saying that G-Man is sorry. He's basically saying that LaMonster is sorry. He's basically saying that, who else he played? I believe, I'm trying to think who else he, yeah, G-Sice is sorry. He's saying that all those good players are sorry, as if they not good at the game at all. Like, you can't just knock Ticino for losing. Like, what is wrong with the community, man? Y'all sitting here knocking him on Twitter, saying he's trash and this and that, just because, you know what I'm saying, he losing against good players. They not sorry players, man. And he's playing, they all playing fair. You know what I'm saying? They playing straight up. And to me, the ISO players, and he lost against TJ too, and they all have 90 win percents. They have 90 win percents, by the way. So a lot of y'all that are saying that don't even have 90 win percents. Y'all probably have 70 some win percents like me. But all y'all just knocking them, saying that like they are just sorry or something. LaMonster has a two-way slashing playmaker that can shoot threes. You know how hard it is to go up against a two-way slashing playmaker? It's not easy. Hall of Fame Clamps, Hall of Fame Intimidator, Gold Pickpocket, and things like that. You think that's easy? Them defensive badges are so overpowered. So yeah, man, don't take it like Ticino just a scrub or something. I understand that, you know what I'm saying, in Australia, he be playing against these players that ain't that good, man. I know. The players ain't that good as the Swiss in America. We know that, man. We know. They not as sweaty as we are in America. We all know we got all type of glass cleaning, lockdown, offensive threat, paint defender type, you know what I'm saying, lineups that we gotta go against, that we see every day in the U.S., America, etc., etc. So we all know the comp over here, man. You ain't gotta, you know what I'm saying, you ain't gotta do all that. But yeah, like I was saying, but we gotta protect Ticino and give him his props, for the simple fact that most YouTubers, they're not going to do this, man. He came over here with 20k to wager over this trash game. He came over here to wager over this trash game. This game is not good, it's dry, and it's boring overall. Imagine wanting to play. You ask yourself this question: I don't care how much money you got. I don't care if you got $1 million, $20 million. You, when you got that much, all you got to do is upload a video and hop straight off. So ask yourself this. Once you have, as a matter of fact, ask yourself this. Would you actually wager over this game when you already don't like it? When it's already boring? When it's the same neighborhood, the same thing from 2K19? See, last year, he just played for free, just for entertainment. He played for free entertainment and turned the community up. He played for free. And then this year, he upgraded and even wagered it. So, for all you guys out there knocking him, man, y'all gotta understand that what he doing is not easy. Nobody, mostly nobody, would not want to wager over this trash game. Why you think G-Man said... he was talking to Annoying. He was basically really getting at Annoying, because Annoying was basically saying that Ticino a streamer and a better player, and all G-Man is an entertaining YouTuber. So G-Man said the reason why he don't stream this game is because it's boring and because it just ain't fun to play. So how can you blame him for not wanting to do that? But as you can see, Ticino is streaming his game, you know what I'm saying, and he's playing for money on it, doing something that ain't no other YouTubers doing the whole year. I don't care what y'all say, you know what I'm saying, about the YouTubers. Listen, I'm not knocking no YouTuber, man. I got respect for all y'all, you know what I'm saying. Keep doing y'all thing, keep grinding. But I'm just saying, what sets Ticino apart and why he should get more, you know what I'm saying, more credibility for this, is because he doing something that most YouTubers are not doing or not doing at all. He's wagering the most comp players over this trash game. Over this trash game. And it's already a hard transition from playing, you know what I'm saying, Australia player or New Zealand players, wherever you play it, to playing, you know what I'm saying, America Switch. That's not easy at all to do. And it takes, you know what I'm saying, some courage and some skill and some heart. Because you're streaming in front of 15K plus. And you playing some players that you're not used to playing to, man. We all know I did my Australia players over there, man. You look at some of Ticino's Twitch streams. They're not as skilled as these players over here. They're way less skilled, man. You'll have a easier time over there playing. But yeah, he's keeping a community lit, man. You gotta respect it. And you gotta, you know what I'm saying, admire at times and just understand that he is a good content creator that's trying to get some good content out there for y'all. Because if we being true, man, the community is really dry right now. The community in the game is really dry right now. Like, we still got the YouTubers out there, you know what I'm saying, that's gonna do their number and do their numbers and make their money. But the community is really dry right now. We really needed this, man. We needed this. We actually needed this, man, because it's making 2K a little drop exciting even more and making people want to do new things. So, and then on top of that, we got side bets going on this and all that type of stuff, man. So it's real, you know what I'm saying, exciting and all that to do. So understand that most YouTubers out here, I'm telling you right now, they not gonna stream and they ain't gonna want to play. They not going to want to play these comp players that they know they're going to get beat by. I'm pretty sure Ticino knew he was going to get beat by some of these YouTubers. I'm pretty sure he knew. Some people that he was playing, he knew he was going to get beat by. Because don't know YouTubers like that. They play a lot of sweaty players. But don't none of them just constantly play 91%, 91%, 91%, 91%, and 91% for money. Only Ticino is doing something like that. Would you want to put your money on the line going against a LaMonster or going against G-Man or, you know what I'm saying, going against T-Jagnum or something like that? Would you really want to put your money on the line? Because I know I would. I'm going to tell you straight up, I'm not going to play. I don't care how good I am. I'm not playing this game for no money. Money is too scarce. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You got to get it how you get it. And I'm not playing. I don't care if I'm a millionaire. I ain't gambling at all. I'm not gambling for no, you know what I'm saying, no 2K. Forget all that. My money is my money. I ain't doing it. You know what I'm saying? If you want to do it like that, then you go ahead and do it. But for all the people out there that, you know what I'm saying, responsible with their money like that, you ain't going to gamble at all. Because, you know what I'm saying, money ain't easy to get. Like, at first it's not, but you know what I'm saying, later on in time it is. But another thing that he is smart on doing, he also said that December, because I've heard a lot about December, you know what I'm saying, like he said, you're gonna get a lot of more money in December because a lot of people gonna be viewing YouTube, you know what I'm saying? It's Christmas and stuff like that. So yeah, he also took advantage of that, knowing that December's coming up. He gonna probably make double what he made because he gonna have that content out plus some more content. So that is a really, really smart thing to do, y'all. So with that being said, man, just respect Ticino, man. Don't throw him no hate. But yeah, if you guys did enjoy this video, man, make sure you spam the like button, like, share, subscribe, y'all. And I'm out, y'all. Peace.